Mike Stilkey's pieces are evocative of an imaginative world that whimsical characters inhabit. For this artist, the expression of blank canvas is not exclusive to ubiquitous painting background. In his hands, record covers, book pages, vintage papers, and books become veritable artistic media.
Okay, so we've seen art in all different and unconventional kind of mediums. However, you've chosen one that's very new to me, which are books. Now, what made you think of this?
Really, I just don't like drawing on anything that's white.
Right.
You know, so I would go to thrift stores and find things to draw on. Mm-hmm. Record covers, book pages, and I was really attracted to drawing on old book pages because they were weathered.
Right.
You know, so one of the first books I ever made, mm-hmm. I made a book that was 100 portraits on old book pages. So I did that, and then I started drawing on the covers, painting on the covers, and it was just a gradual sort of action.
So it was a progression.
Yeah, it was a progression.
Creating these giant pieces.
Yes.
So when you're choosing the books that you use, are there a technique to it?
Color-wise, yeah, I tend to keep the colored books to the outside where I'm not painting, because there's a tremendous amount of dark books, like black books,
right.
Like thousands. So I'll keep the black books in the middle, paint over that, and keep all the colored pieces. Or if they have great titles, I'll keep them on the sides
right.
as well.
What's the biggest challenge that you find in terms of the process of creating these giant pieces?
Mainly the texture of the books, and also the gaps between the books.
Okay.
You know, every book takes the paint differently.
Right.
So it's taken a long time to figure out which books to use in these.
After Mike Stilkey's recent exhibition in Times Square, Hong Kong, Fully Booked held a special exhibition of his newest book sculpture entitled Discarded Romance here in Manila.
Okay, so we're here in the trenches of literature where 4,000 books are scattered around preparing for your art, right?
Correct.
Wow. There are so many books here and it seems like there's an actual technique to it.
Yeah.
You know, they're numbered. But can you walk me through the process from the beginning? For example, how do you source the books? Which books do you choose?
They're all discarded books that come from the library.
Right, right.
You know, the first time I ever went to the library, I asked them if they had books that they were going to discard and they said no. And I said,
right,
oh,
right.
Well, you know, I do these paintings of the books and I showed them a picture of what I did and the guy looked at me and he was like, oh my gosh, you know, come
yeah.
downstairs.
Take the books, take
yeah,
the
yeah,
books.
And he took me down to this basement and opened it up to the secret room and he's like, take as many as you want.
So after you collect the books, what's your next step?
First thing is I have to stack them.
Right.
You know, so I stack them in sections. That's why they're all numbered like this.
Right.
And then I build the piece and it sort of, you know, goes up like a puzzle. Mm-hmm. And then once the piece is up, then I can really see the painting.
After Mike stacks all the books and the pieces up, he starts painting. His inspiration comes from his everyday life, often inspired by characters that populate his domestic atmosphere, like his wife and his cat. The subjects in his art convey a narrative of exactly what happens in his daily life. Mike Stilkey's works only prove that art can most certainly be born from many things that we use every day. All it takes is some imagination and the willpower to see the vision through.